What's going on, guys? We're bringing a new trade sim video today, looking at the trade that just went down less than an hour ago. Duncan Keith being traded to the Edmonton Oilers for Caleb Jones and a third round pick. Now, when I first heard about this trade, it was Frank Cervelli's tweet here that said, "Pending trade call sounds like Hawks Duncan Keith will indeed be heading to the Oilers in exchange for Caleb Jones and a mid round pick, third or fourth, final details still being ironed out." Now, when I heard that, I tweeted out, "Only way this is decent for Edmonton is if Chicago retains 50% on Keith and the mid round pick is a conditional fourth." And then like 20 minutes later, Elliot Friedman tweeted out, "Keith for Caleb Jones in a third, no salary retained." So I couldn't believe that. In my eyes, Keith still has some value, just that veteran presence, the leadership. He's won Norris trophies, he's won 3 Stanley Cups, he's won Olympic gold medals. Edmonton Oilers, you look at their team, they really don't have a guy like that who has won. So in my eyes, I felt like Duncan Keith at 50% for Caleb Jones wasn't too bad of a trade, especially when you consider the fact that Caleb Jones most likely was the player that Seattle was going to take from Edmonton in the expansion draft. Now Seattle really doesn't have anyone to take in my eyes, so that might be a 1+ for Edmonton, but taking on the full $5.5 million salary that Keith has and then giving up a third round pick on top of that to take on the salary, help out Chicago when Keith only was going to get traded to Western Canada or Seattle, I think. So basically like Edmonton, maybe Calgary, Vancouver, Seattle. I don't know how Ken Holland didn't do better on this trade. So like I was saying, you look at the team, very young team, like no one yet over 30. I'm trying to think, do they have a player on this team that's over 30? Kulikov was 30 right on, Chris Russell's 33, Tur's 31. But yeah, like you have no real like veteran winner on this team. So I do think Keith helps Edmonton in one aspect, and that's why I would have given up Caleb Jones, who they clearly aren't a huge fan of. He scratched all the time. Like I said, I think he gets taken by Seattle, but to take on the full contract, to give up a third round pick on top of it, it makes no sense to me. So I'll look at the two players in this trade, and we'll see whether or not EA thinks it's a good one. I'll have to go to defenseman here. You can see Caleb Jones' value isn't that crazy. 23 years old, now 24, 80 overall. He's making 850K for 2 more years, so real life, 1 more year. Roll there, top 6 defenseman, medium top 6 potential. Was a 4th round pick back in 2015. Edmonton actually could have had such a sick 2015 draft. Obviously, McDavid first overall. Could have taken Barzal instead of trading that pick for Griffin Einhart. They also got Ethan Bear and Caleb Jones. I think John Marino as well they got before trading him to Pittsburgh. So they could have had one of the best drafts ever. Again, Caleb Jones, I think he's like a good bomb pair defenseman, low-end top 4 defenseman. And I think, you know, that's kind of what they have him as in-game. Again, because he scratched so much for Oilers, I feel like we really haven't seen enough of him. He could be better than we think, but he also could be worse than we think. Now, at the time of making this, it actually doesn't say what year the third round pick is. And seeing as Edmonton doesn't have a second this year, but they do have a second next year, I'm going to guess the third's 2022, especially if they think they'll do better next year than they did this year. Could be, you know, a later third in the draft. So, hopefully, there's some small win there. It's a 2022 third opposed to 2021. And then Duncan Keith here will add on Chicago's side. No salary retained. You can see he's got a lot more value there as in-game. He's 85 overall. Again, this is EA's roster and ratings, not mine. I felt like if I didn't mind, it wouldn't really make sense for the video. So 37 years old, he's actually gonna turn 38, I think, in 4 days, making $5.5 million for 2 more years, not 3. Rules top 4 defenseman, potential's top 4, because obviously at this age he is whatever his role is. Second round pick back in 2002. So great pick for the Blackhawks, obviously. They still have his speed, I think, a little bit too high. At his age, Keith's definitely slowed down. Offensively, he's still not too bad. Defensively, though, he's definitely, you know, lost a step. I think that D-awareness, shot block, stick check could be down a bit. Physical, never that physical guy. You can see there. I think his physical is actually pretty accurate. Definitely still has, I think, 90 poise. Again, he is a leader. You're not really going to lose that, even if you do lose a bit of athletic ability. So, in-game, he looks a bit overvalued, in my opinion. Now, even in-game, Ken Holland does want him. You can see the Oilers like Keith, and their third round pick is on the block. Caleb Jones is not, but I feel like if we offer this to Holland, he's definitely going to say yes. I do want to mention the reason they have records, we're actually at the trade deadline right now, and I had to sim to the trade deadline so that the trade would work in terms of salary reasons. Obviously, this is happening in the offseason, but if it went all the way to the offseason, then their ratings might change. If, say, Caleb Jones had an awesome year, or if Keith had an awesome year as well, want to keep the ratings as they are. So let's see what happens here. I feel like Edmonton definitely says yes to this. Trade's accepted. Okay, so we'll see if it's now accepted from Edmonton's side. And after the trade, guys, here's an updated look at the Blackhawks defensive core. I got Zadorov on the top pair with Boqvist just because they're getting a +5. Zadorov, I think, was on the bottom pair before that. Also, he's actually a pending UFA, so I'm not sure if he'll return to Chicago. The rest of these guys, though, are under contract. Boqvist will definitely be part of the team unless... I've seen some rumors. People think they might trade him for Seth Jones, and that's part of, like, this getting Caleb Jones to help entice Seth Jones to come to Chicago. I think even at Boquist for Seth Jones, I don't know, he's still so young. He has so much potential. And I know Seth Jones' analytics aren't the greatest. I feel like I would definitely want him on my team, but I'm not going to give up my best defensive prospect for him. You can see Murphy DeHaan, solid second pair. Again, Chicago, I think, definitely rebuilding. The fact that they're willing to trade away Duncan Keith, even if he has gotten worse, I think that's just, you know, very telling. They're willing to let that leader out of the locker room. I'll give you guys a look here at Jones on the Blackhawks. I feel like you not only can see what Caleb Jones looks like, but maybe also what Seth Jones might look like with that Jones there on the back. Will it be a C Jones we see next season? Time will tell. All right, guys, we're now trying to trade from Edmonton's perspective. With only an 18-man roster, I was actually able to move it around and get cap space for Duncan Keith at the start of the season. I can see the Blackhawks do not have him on the trade block, but his value there looks actually to be a bit less than we traded him. So he must have been having a decent season when I simmed up to the trade deadline. Like, it's less there than Borgstrom, less than Kubalik, but like, it's still decent. Jones in the third, they like both of them. And the value looks pretty equal, so I think there's a chance this goes through. I forgot to mention the trade difficulty is on medium. Let's see what Blackhawks say here. Trade's accepted. Wow, okay. So I guess in-game, EA feels like this is a fair trade as both sides accepted it on medium difficulty. Again, in real life, I feel like Edmonton got absolutely fleeced. I'm not gonna lie, I always liked Ken Holland. He helped us win a Stanley Cup in Detroit, but after seeing this latest trade and some of the other moves he made for Detroit, I am very happy Steve Yzerman is now the GM of the Red Wings. And after the trade, guys, just a quick look at Edmonton Oilers defensive core. We got Nurse and Barry on the top pair. Obviously, there's a good chance Barry doesn't go back to Edmonton, but I feel like for the right price, I would definitely bring him back. I mean, he led defensemen in scoring. I know first one ever to not get a Norse vote because of that, but clearly, having him on the power play, getting those secondary assists with McDavid and Draisaitl did help. So, in my eyes, Barry, if you can get him back for, say, I don't know, $4 million, something like that, just to be, you know, QB on the power play, I would definitely do it. I've got Bear there with Keith on the second pair, Kulikov, Larson on the bottom pair. Kulikov's probably gone. And if Barry's gone, I feel like Evan Bouchard maybe slots into that role as the offensive defenseman for Edmonton. I'll show you guys what Keith looks like on the Oilers. Definitely that'll be a weird one. He's been with Chicago for 1,100 games, I saw. Let me actually do a quick look here. Yeah, 1,138. That doesn't include this season, so it's actually, you know, closer to 1,200 now. So, Duncan Keith on the Edmonton Oilers. Like I said, it's going to look strange. There you go. Duncan Keith, number two Edmonton Oilers. Yeah, definitely is looking weird. But like I said, I think one, you know, small win for the Oilers is you don't have a player like Keith. I mentioned it. Look at how young your roster is. Not only do you not have like a veteran like him, you don't have a winner like him. Neil, you know, he did go to Stanley Cup final with Vegas. Turris has never won anything. Same with Ennis. So hopefully Keith can come in and help in some intangible ways. I know people don't like talking about that, but that's really the only positive, I think, for Edmonton. Chicago, you shed $5.5 million in cap space. You get a decent young defenseman in Caleb Jones, who maybe helps you sign Seth Jones. You also get a third round pick. So huge win for Chicago. I see why Edmonton did it, but they definitely paid way too much of a price. Let me know what you guys think about this trade in the comment section below. If you guys enjoyed this one, leave a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, hit the sub button. And as always, guys, thanks so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.